ready to match the stars from In the Beginning, McLean Stevenson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, from Sugar Time, D.D. Carr, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 78. And now, here's the star of Match Game 78, Gene Ritter.
All right, Jenny. Shall we have a go at it?
Good. Are you all quite ready?
Sure.
All right. Ready, Chuck?
I just told him the farmerette number's been cut, so he's very upset.
Oh, that's too bad.
I just him to take his hat off, because it's so dull. Come on, Chuck.
Charles.
It's home in a drawer and just continue and tell about the new star wheel and shut up.
All right. We have this wonderful star wheel where one of our contestants here can win $10,000 in one single match. Now let's say hello to Madeline, Monica, and Dolores Alex here. Madeline and Monica, the current champ, with $1,800 to her credit. We just met Dolores, who works for Head Start, and you've been with them a long time. And they are demonstrably a marvelous organization. And
we're trying very hard.
Yes, indeed. And we hope that the dingbats in Washington will keep funding Head Start forever and forever.
That's right.
Nothing personal, dingbats. Now, we'll continue in round one here in a moment or so, but right now we've got this for you. Here we go. Now, this is a round one question, belongs to Madeline LaMonica, and what it says is, Frank said, my friend Joe is really kinky. He's the guy in the guy who mentally undresses blanks. My friend Joe is really kinky. He's the kind of guy who mentally undresses blanks.
Is that too kinky?
No, it's wonderful.
Oh, wait a minute. I haven't seen.
Come on, put it in the slot. Let's
I got it, and I've got the answer.
I'll bet you got it. Frank said, my friend Joe is really kinky. He's the kind of guy who mentally undresses blanks.
All I could think of is other men.
Other men.
Yeah.
Well, that's kinky.
That's what I thought. There's another name for that, but we won't go into it.
She said it would be kinky if Frank mentally undressed, if Joe mentally undressed other men.
Well, it depends on where you shop. I had guys, but crossed it out and said girls.
Well, what's wrong with that? Don't you do that all the time?
No, he.
Yeah, but it ain't kinky.
No, it's not kinky for you to mentally undress a girl. Now,
I know,
just
but
imagine.
Sex is dirty.
Sex is not dirty.
It's not dirty?
No. Sex is a beautiful, wonderful experience.
Well, I'm going to call my folks right after the show and tell them, boy.
Yeah. You mean they quit? Hello there.
He says this is the pathetic award. He's raw, as usual. He's dead.
Let the audience decide about her answer.
You said really kinky.
Kinky.
Kinky. Now, there's nothing unkinky about a man undressing another man medley or any of that, but what is really kinky is a man undressing statues. Those doors will please leave the building.
Okay, you're up. You have a
this
shot.
This is in honor of Sister Marie La Salette from Lawrence O'Toole, who is a great teacher and a wonderful woman.
Stinks, your answer.
Give him a chance. But that's kinky.
Well, so is that.
So is statues. It's not kinky at all. Really? All right, Dee Dee. This guy is really kinky. He's the kind of guy who mentally undresses
children.
Children, that would be kinky.
That's kinky.
Okay.
That's kinky.
That's also kinky. Other men is conventional, don't you think so?
All I'm saying is kinky, is it?
No.
Thank you. Nudists.
Nudists?
Getting down to the bare bones.
I can just see them ripping their skin off. Oh, dear me. Show us something kinky.
Notice.
Notice.
Two Great Minds, part two.
Okay.
That's part two.
Now we go to round two here. Dolores, you may have A or B.
This is very close
I'm
game.
I B this time.
Yes, it is a close game, zip to zip. I don't want to be saying I got to double these up here, bow down, King Kong was thrown out of the baseball stadium because when they told him it was time for the seventh inning stretch, Kong went out and stretched the blank. All right, in baseball, it's traditional. They have the seventh inning stretch.
Yeah.
If you're rooting for one team, you stretch in the first half of the seventh inning. If you're rooting for the visiting team, you stretch in the second half of the
stretch.
You get up and stretch your legs and yawn and go.
Oh, you mean just like a
regular stretch? Yeah, you stretch.
No, me neither.
Well, now, this, I think, is a wonderful one. There's one obvious, terrific answer.
Well, I think I have it.
Well, I'll bet you have it. King Kong was thrown out of the baseball stadium because when they told him it was time for the seventh inning stretch, Kong went out and stretched the blank. Got thrown out of the baseball stadium.
Oh.
Oh.
He stretched the field.
Oh. By Jove, she blew it again.
Oh.
Well... No, I don't think that's going to work for you, but we'll find out right now. Okay, McLean.
Well, I went for filth and kink. I mean, really.
Combine them all.
My first reaction was nude guys. But
he said stadium.
I said stadium.
That's a match. I tell you, hips and that. Stadium. I'll be darned. I really am surprised because I thought her answer was so dreadful that no one over here would say it. You see, that's what I'm taken by aback here. What do you say?
We have Dick Martin, we have Scully Mitchell, and then we have McLean Stevenson.
Yes.
Now, I don't know, but I think maybe this is a good answer. I don't know, but we'll let everybody else. I said he went out and stretched the team he didn't like.
Stretch the team he didn't like.
Right. Now, isn't that a good answer, dear?
That's an excellent answer.
Thank
excellent
you.
Answer.
Are you lying to me just
no,
because
no.
you've got the reservation made?
No. The idea here is Kong went out and stretched a human being of one
no,
sort or another.
No, that's not what it says. There's no way does that imply that, Dr. Grenman.
Oh, yes.
No, it doesn't. Where does it say that? Where does it say it implies a human being? That's your opinion of the question.
That's right. What is your opinion?
Roberta Peters is my best friend, right? Oh,
right.
Don't you know, I love her?
Yes, indeed.
What's her married name?
Field.
Field.
You must forgive me, Dolores.
I
thought
you
were going to bottom
out
three.
You're just talking yourself right down the drain.
Well, I mean, I was thinking you'd go out and stretch the
MC.
Something like that, you see.
I like more for the other
sure,
team.
Sure, they cheer you. You're here every week.
Okay, Cutter, what did you say? Kong went out and stretched the...
Baseball diamond?
Baseball diamond, no! I tell you, I am utterly humiliated. Humiliated! Richard, save me. Say umpire.
Well, no, Julie Harris is my very best friend.
Julie Harris.
I said pitcher.
Pitcher. All right. See, there's some human
understand
being was really the idea there, right?
Who started that pitcher?
The pitcher, right. So there we are. Three for her, and that means you'll have to go to work when it's your turn. Right now, this for you. Here we go. Right. This is the last question. Madeline... You've done it before. Let's see if you do it again. You need three to tie, four to win. Did you hear about the tailor's wife?
No.
Giving birth to Siamese twins.
Oh, God.
It's strange because they're joined at the blank. Tailor's wife.
Tailor's
wife. Now think
wife.
Of the operative words. Tailor's wife, Siamese
wife.
Twins, joined at the blank. Do you understand me?
Yes.
Why does she keep looking at what I'm writing?
Because that's how
because she can't think of an answer. That's why she keeps looking. Wonderful. All right. Madeline LaMonica. Did you hear about the tailor's wife giving birth to Siamese twins? It's strange because they're joined at the...
I can't think of anything. Joined at the feet? No.
Did you hear when I laid it out very carefully
for
them?
Yeah, I know.
Tailor's wife, Siamese twins, joined at the...
No, I can't think of
anything. Some tailor's phrase or device or whatever, right?
Do?
Yes, but I don't think you should be cruel to Madeline. God knows she's trying. She's won $42 million and got big dimples.
She does have big dimples.
Oh, she's got big dimples, boy.
She's got $1,800, too.
Oh, yes, Madeline.
She can buy four dimples, have them all over her face.
She can
one
have some of mine.
No.
Yes, you've got a beaut, too, right there.
Because, I mean, you're really not mad at Madeline. She's lovely.
Oh, she is.
And the audience isn't really mad at us when they boo and hiss and
no,
shout
at they're funning at us. They're having a good time,
and give
right.
Dumb answers like zipper.
Zipper is wonderful. Don't boo him, dummies. That's an excellent answer. Hello.
Madeline, home, da-da-da. I didn't say zipper, and I didn't say whatever it was she said, which I can't remember.
She said feet.
I said fly.
There's another one. Doing the same, Chuck.
Chuck said zipper, Gene.
Okay, Chuck. So far, you got zippers all the way along there. Now, Madeline, you must match everybody here in the bottom tier to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Dee Dee Carr, what have you got?
I'm very good friends with Richard Dawson.
Yes.
And I just wanted to mention that. And I said seams.
Yes! Seams. Inseam and inseam. All right. Now we'll say goodbye to Madeline LaMonica, who's going to leave here with $1,800. Go right over there.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for being with us.
Thank you very much.
Madeline LaMonica, ladies and gentlemen. There she goes. Here comes our big star wheel here with one spin of that wheel. If you get lucky, you can win $10,000. But to begin with, as usual, with the audience match, here we go. We polled a studio audience not too long ago, and we said, you write down your best answer to this. Frankie Blank, if you match the answer they wrote down most frequently, you get $500. For matching the second most popular, $250, and $100 for the third. And these good people will give you some suggestions.
Richard.
Frankie and Johnny.
Frankie and Johnny.
Betty.
Frankie Lane.
Frankie Lane.
Frankie. Anne McLean.
Frankie Avalon.
Frankie Avalon, Frankie Lane, and Frankie and Johnny.
The first name that came to my mind was Frankie Avalon.
It was. Okay, one thing we forgot to tell you. We had the Southern California Geriatric Society in here. Everybody was over 90 that day. They pulled that off.
I'm glad, too.
I'm only funning you, my dear. No, Frankie Avalon is her choice. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom as usual and reveal the $100 response. Frankie Lane is one answer that we got up there from Betty White. May we see the next one, please? Frankie Avalon, congratulations to you. Now the audience applauded loud and long for Frankie Avalon, so apparently they thought that was going to be on top, the big one. Now what do you say?
Frankie and Johnny.
Frankie and Johnny. Change your mind. You're a very fickle bunch. Slide it. Yeah. Okay. Now, you've won $250, which means at least you'll be playing for us 10 times that amount, or $2,500. But you can double that stake if you have a lucky spin on our new star wheel here. Every celebrity's name is on the wheel. You're going to spin that wheel in a moment or so and see which celebrity you'll be playing with and for how much, whether you'll be playing for the $2,500 or double that amount. Because if it falls in one of the star areas where it is right now, you see, that light comes on, and that means you'll be playing for double the amount. We'll put it right up here. It must make one rotation. Grab it and give it a good spin, and good luck to you. There it is. Will she play for $2,500 or double that amount?
Double.
All right, let's hope she gets a double.
You're going to be playing with Betty White in Double the Amount or $5,000. Good luck to Dolores Alex.
Here it is. It says, Sacred Blank. That's S-A-C-R-E-D. Sacred Blank. All right, Dolores, give us the answer that she's given. We give you $5,000. Sacred.
I hope it comes through for me this time. Sacred Heart.
Sacred Heart. Well, we're going to find out if it comes through for you or not, Dolores. Betty, she says Sacred Heart will match you for the $5,000. What do you say?
But you also make a sacred vow, don't
a
you?
A sacred vow.
With all your heart.
With all your heart.
Today's consolation prizes are first, Kool-Aid fashionable sunglasses that win admiring stares while protecting from annoying glare. 86 eye catching styles see what you're missing with Kool-Aid polarized sunglasses. And Cashmere Passions by Clarissa Roth. Follow Love's Runaway in pursuit for the love of man she cannot have, and paperback from Warner Books. And a wall clock and a supply of Golden Rain macaroni and cheddar dinners made with enriched elbow macaroni, creamier cheddar cheese and other natural flavors from Golden Rain Macaroni Company. And a tote bag and a supply of Lip Quencher. Wet your whistle with Lip Quencher, the moisturizing lipstick by Chapstick in 24 wet, wonderful colors. Ready with more of Match Game and Gene Raven.
And here is Larry Shelberg. Say hello to Larry.
Gene, how are you?
Well, let's find out a little bit about you, sir.
Well, Gene, I'm from Smithville, Missouri, which is just a little bit north of Kansas City, Missouri.
Yeah.
I work for an airline back there. I've got a wife, six kids, five girls, one boy,
yeah,
and one little granddaughter.
Well.
And I just enjoy life and sports.
Yeah. Yes.
That kind, too.
Yeah. Naturally. You got to try another hobby, though, Larry. Okay, good luck to you, Larry. Nice to have you here. You may have A or B.
Okay, let's start with B.
B it is. For Larry the Fertile. At the zoo. Jane said.
Pardon?
The Jane said. She was at the zoo, you see.
Jane was at the
Jane.
Zoo.
Jane was at the zoo. She said, the zookeeper
zoo
must really love animals. I just saw a blank with a hickey. Jane said, the zookeeper must really love animals. I just saw a blank with a hickey.
Sweetheart, you've got to get the combination
That's like a girl's talk, isn't it?
No, they talk. Have you ever heard a sibilant S? How many sibilant S's have you heard on girls?
Well, now,
speak, Betty.
Wait a minute. Read this aloud. Would you please read that aloud?
At the zoo. Jane said.
Said? Did you hear the sibilant?
Jane said, the zookeeper must really love animals.
Animals?
I just saw a blank with a hickey.
See? She just said, I just saw a blank with a hickey.
It's still not right.
Now, what's wrong with it?
I left out the name of the city.
Oh, at the L.A. Zoo.
Right.
All right. Everybody ready? Well, one to go here. Okay, she'll be ready in a second. Larry, at the zoo, Jane said the zookeeper must really love animals. I just saw a blank with a hickey.
A chimpanzee.
A chimp. Yeah. He loved the chimp. What can you say? What do you say?
I say a hippo with a hickey.
Hippo. Oh, boy, that would be tough. Huh? You'd really have to
Wouldn't
pucker up real
cute?
Hard to get through that leathery skin. See a big red hickey on the...
Oh, I thought like a zits from eating candy bars and stuff.
Oh, I see.
Oh, you mean like on when you're in high school in the back seat.
Yeah.
Oh, that's...
Oh, you mean you've lived all these years and you never really knew what a hickey was?
Don't you remember you talking to the guy that thought sex was dirty?
Oh, we have. Hello, Brett.
I love a chimpanzee.
There it is. One. Chuck, you made it two.
I don't know what the judges feel. I hope so. I said baboon. Yeah.
Baboon. There's another monkey. two different things, she says. Dee Dee, what do you say?
How about an orangutan?
Orangutan. I don't know.
Well, no, if they accept that, I feel quite confident about my answer. Giraffe.
Yeah. Giraffe. Yeah. Can that be a big hickey?
Well, can you beat that?
I can. Show us your hickey.
I want to stay with those hips if it's the last hippo.
Hippo! So three for him. Not bad for a first rounder. Now this for you. Next time, this will be the cast of characters.
Henry Morgan. Brett Summer. Charles Nelson Reilly, Deborah Lee Scott, Richard Dawson, and George Beaufort.
We've had a wonderful time. Join us next time, please do. And that's Game 78. Thank you all. I love you.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Cookson, Bill Todman production. This program was edited for broadcast.